10 vitamin D myths. Myth number 1. You can't get vitamin D from sunbeds. Yes, you can. You should go for the sunbeds that emit UVB radiation. It will produce vitamin D in your skin. Myth number 2. At some age, you can't absorb vitamin D from supplements. No, that's wrong. Vitamin D supplements are good for all ages. If you're newborn from 0 to 1 year, you should take about 400 IU of vitamin D, and all other ages should take at least 1000 IU per day. Myth number 3. If you're fat, you'll absorb more vitamin D in your blood. No, that's wrong. You absorb more of the vitamin D in your fat, and then it will be less available for the rest of your body. That's why you actually need to take more vitamin D, about the double doses. And you should actually check with your doctor to take, you monitor which levels you are. Myth number 4. You can absorb vitamin D through windows. No, that's wrong. The windows, the glass windows, will absorb or reflect. According to Dr. Hollick, glass will absorb the UVB radiation, but the most probably it will be reflected by the glass. Myth number 5. Treatment with vitamin D supplements D2 and D3 are just as effective. No, that's wrong. Many studies show that D2 is less effective than D3. Dr. Hollick says that it's good no matter what, but I think he's thinking about that you can take more D2 than D3 or something. If you take like 50,000 EU of vitamin D2, then it's probably less of a significance. But there are studies that say that this is not true. But I still recommend D2 because it's plant-based and it's better for the environment. Myth number 6. Vitamin D levels in the blood of 16 nanograms per milliliter is enough. Well, that's questionable. In Denmark, we have the reference range from about 60 nanograms to about 50 nanograms, which is, should be the safe range of vitamin D levels. But according to Dr. Hollick, you should, if you're under 20 nanograms per milliliter, you're deficient. And when you're between 20 and 30, you're insufficient. If you're above 30, between 30 and 100, there is the reference range of Dr. Hollick. And if you're between 40 and 60, he says that's the ideal range. You can get intoxicated with vitamin D if you take too much supplementation. You can't get it from UVB radiation. But if this only happens if you get above 150 nanograms per milliliter. Myth number 7. Sunscreen lotion does not inhibit the vitamin D production in the skin. Yes, it does. It will actually reflect the UVB radiation. And the sun protection factor of 8 will reduce the UVB radiation by 90% and therefore also reduce the production of vitamin D of 90%. And if you use sun protection factor SPF 30, it will be reduced by 99%. That's why many people are deficient, even though they are out in the sun, because they use sun protection all the time. You need some sun exposure if you want to have healthy vitamin D levels. Myth number 8. A shower after sunbathing inhibits the production of vitamin D in the skin. No, that's not correct. Vitamin D production happens in the inner layers of the skin. So if you wash the outer layers, it doesn't matter. You could argue, I'm an old fireman, so I know a little bit about burning the skin. So what is recommended is that you actually put some water if you get a sunburn. I don't recommend to get sunburned, but if you're unlucky to get that, it may help you if you take a cold shower afterwards. Myth number 9. You need to take small doses of vitamin D daily to get an effective vitamin D treatment. No, that's not correct. Actually, Dr. Hollick treats his patient with 50,000 IU of vitamin D every second week. And if the patient forgets it one time, then the patient will get 100,000 IU in one go that month. Myth number 10. You should take your vitamin D after a fatty meal because vitamin D is fat soluble. No, that's not true. But according to Dr. Hollick, you can even take a vitamin D pill on an empty stomach. But it's just, he has shown in his labs that it's just as effective 45 in juice or taken in a pill. So, go figure!